Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and the saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let's pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servant may hold fast in their life to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. On the day of Pentecost, Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to my words. You who are children of Israel, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man, delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad and my tongue has exalted. My flesh too will dwell in hope. Because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence. My brothers, one can confidentially say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus, so of this we are all witnesses. Exalted at the right hand of God, he poured forth the promise of the Holy Spirit that he received from the Father, as you both see and hear." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord, are you, O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup? You it is who hold fast my lot. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night my heart exhorts me. I see the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Keep me safe, O God, in your hope. Therefore my father is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. You will show me the path to life, fullness of joys in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
We are reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce the news to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on their way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. While they were going, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priest all that had happened. The chief priest assembled with the elders and took counsel. Then they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers, telling them, you ought to say, his disciple came by night and stole him while we were asleep. And if this gets to the ears of the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble. The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has circulated among the Jews to the present day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus, someone says, our heart is a garden, and our thoughts are the seed that we plant in our hearts. If we have a positive thought, a good thought, we will have a good flowers. And if we have bad thoughts, we will have bad flowers. It is up to each and every one of us to decide what flowers do we need, the garden of our heart. The thoughts, when you come to the today's gospel, the women were having two kinds of thoughts. One was fear, because they thought that Jesus' body was stone. The other one was joyful thoughts. When they saw Christ is alive, they were overjoyed. So, us here human beings, we have these two kinds of thoughts, good and bad, or fearful or joyful. But we should not give a place to our heart to overtake the fearfulness over the joy. If we give the chance, that chance, then we will not have a future thought. We will think that we have no future. Once we think like that, and we feel that our life is so miserable. Now we all are experiencing this kind of life, a miserable life, where fear is overruling our hearts. But Jesus says, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I am alive. For that, what gives us the hope? Because Jesus is alive. Jesus is with us. He will take care of everything. We have to put all our trust, despite all our fearfulness, we have to put all our trust at the feet of Jesus. And He is always telling us, my dear children, don't be afraid. Amen. In faith and in hope in the good news of Christ's resurrection, let us turn to God as we give voice to our prayers.
For the Church of Christ, may the power of the Holy Spirit work through her in proclaiming the good news and the mercy of God in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Christians throughout the world persecuted for their faith, may God uphold and strengthen them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the poor and vulnerable in the world, may God lift them to lives free from suffering and fear. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit grant us grace in our lives and joy in our mission of proclaiming the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our beloved dead, may they be united with the saints in heaven, giving glory to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And for the intentions of Josefa Urias, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Heavenly Father, confident in your mercy and filled with faith and hope in the promise of Easter joy, we ask that you hear our prayers through your Son, Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the
glory of his name, for our good, the good of our Christ. Accept graciously, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your peoples, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light arise to eternal life, that he holds of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has arisen. Therefore, overcome with the Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by setting down your spirit upon them like the deep fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection and you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that we have found us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. him and with him and in him. Our God, Almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, our glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and prompted by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only for the word in which my soul shall be healed.
Even if the church doors remain closed and I can't participate in the Holy Mass, I will not be distressed because the Blessed Trinity dwells within me. God took residence in my heart when I got baptized into the church, the body of Christ. Today, when my heart longs for his precious body and blood, when I miss him terribly, the Lord consoles me from within. Child, don't be sad. I am here with you. Within you, I am the Infinite One. I am beyond space and time. I am still close. I can hear you. I can feel you. Now, when your heart deeply misses the Holy Mass and receiving my body and blood, understand that you can always receive me in spiritual communion. When you desire and pray thus, I come to you the same way as I have come before in the Holy Communion. You continue to remain my own. Yes, you still belong to me. Spiritual Communion Prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come into my heart spiritually. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself to you wholly. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let's pray. May the grace of this Paschal Sacrament abound in our minds, we pray, our Lord, and make those you have set on the way of eternal salvation worthy of your gifts. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God, the mercy is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.